Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of Gavinski's Tutorials. Today I'm going to do a walkthrough of Streichfett by Waldorf. So this is based on their hardware that in turn was based on classic 1970s string machines. So if you watched my video on audio things, RES-09, which was based on the old Roland string machine, you'll recognize the sound here, so I decided to use the same MIDI so it could be easy for people to compare the sound of these. So I'm looking at the iPad version here. This just came out for iOS. But it's the same, I think, as the desktop version, which is very similar to the hardware. Maybe there are some differences. So, we definitely don't go to these kind of string machines for realistic string sounds, right? That is for sure. But they do have their own charm. Some people love these, some don't. Let us know in the comments which camp you're in. So, let's walk through it. So we have two sections, a strings section and a solo section. The solo section is monophonic unless you're using it in the layered mode. The string section is poly. So we have some controls in each. Let me just first mix the balance. So I'm going to move the balance over to just strings. So now we're not hearing the solo section at all. Let me turn it up a little bit. So with this registration knob, we morph between the different waveforms. This uses additive synthesis, I think. That's very pleasing to play with. I'm really glad that you can morph. Let me take down the reverb so you can just hear these without any reverb. So they're quite gritty. So I've set this here at the moment to bass, but we can have two octaves or we can have just a higher octave. Let's put it on bass first and just cycle through. Okay, let's try the higher octave. Both. And here we have two choices of chorus. One's called chorus. And one's called string. It's faster, grittier. And we can have both together if we want. I think I prefer just the chorus one. Then below we have this crescendo knob for attack, basically. And then we have release. Okay, let me use the balance knob. Let's just go over to the solo section. So here again we have a knob where we can move between these different sounds. And we have a choice of higher or a lower layer. Or we can have both. We have decay and release. Let me turn on the sustain. Okay, there. So that'll be release if you have sustain on, otherwise it's the decay time. Now that changes the sound quite a lot, as does this attack option. So if you have this down at lower settings, you get, let's bring that down, you get this very percussive sound. Right, you hear that? And then here we have this tremolo. No separate control of depth and rate. I would definitely have preferred two knobs, one for depth, one for rate. So playing with the balance and all the other controls, you know, morphing between these different sounds, bringing in the reverb. It can get a lot louder, by the way, with high reverb amount. You know, we can get a reasonable variety of sounds. Chorus off. One weakness is the preset system. You just have these buttons here. I guess this is like the hardware. You got two banks with eight buttons in each. I mean, I really don't see any advantage. I don't see any advantage to keeping a preset system like that. There are some options in here. I haven't even explored these. I would not use an internal preset system like that. I would rather just use the preset system of the host app, where I can save as many presets as I like. If we go to settings, you have control over the tuning, and that's a very fine adjustable control, so that's great. Let me see if double tap resets. Ah, no, it doesn't actually. Oh, what's happened there? Let me see. Okay, we've also got a transpose option as well. Up or down 12 semitones. You can control the pitch bend range, so you've got a pitch wheel down here in the keyboard. Notice there's a mod wheel that does a bit of vibrato. So you can play the mod wheel in here as well, or you just set it to something you want. Interesting. You have a choice of whether it's fixed velocity or not. Background audio would be useful for the standalone version. So yeah, animate knob. Animate knob is a single control of LFO, rate, and depth for this registration section. You'd probably prefer to just control that with an external LFO. Strings registration, that's this one. So I think I've covered everything there. Hope you find this useful, guys. And I'll see you in the next video. Take care. All the best.